I just want to say first start by saying a huge thank you to Carolina. It's been so nice having these conversations with you over the expanded kind of period of the year. And also a thanks to you, Emilio, Andrea, and the whole of the group team for this invitation to join you today. And a big congratulations also what you've fostered over the last 20 years. This community is really very special to see and also to be a part of. I'm very happy to be joined by two colleagues and friends whose work and whose thinking I really respect, and looking forward also to how this conversation sort of develops. I'm going to give a sort of abridged version in terms of their bio. So Claudia Segura is a curator and cultural producer based here in Barcelona. She's the curator of exhibitions and collections at MACBA. Previously, she was director and chief curator of Ence Arte in Bogota, where she curated exhibitions and site-specific projects by artists such as Amalia Pica, Los Carpinteros, Alia Ferit, amongst others. She was coordinator of cultural initiatives at La Caja Foundation in Barcelona, an external curator of the Mardin Biennial in Turkey, and a mentor at the Caño Laboratory at the Art Museum of the Universidad Nacional de Colombia. She's curated exhibitions internationally in Mexico, Colombia, the UK, Turkey, and also wanted to highlight here, she's the co-curator of the exhibition of Maria Teresa Incapi at MACBA, which is really excellent and not to be missed. Gala Poraskim is an artist working between LA and London. Her work is about the social and political context that influence how intangible things such as sounds, language, and history have been framed through the fields of linguistics, history, and conservation. The work considers the way institutions shape inherited codes and forms, and conversely, how objects can shape the context in which they're placed. Her solo exhibitions include Cadiz, Amant, Gasworks, The Fowler in LA, alongside group presentations at the Whitney Biennial, São Paulo, and Gwangju Biennials, amongst others. And Gala was a resident at Delfina Foundation last year during our collectings practice season. So I think the kind of title of this discussion and sort of open-ended questions that are sort of inherent have emerged from various different sources, conversations that we've had with Carolina, as well as the most recent season of collectings practice, which really centered around the nature of conservation and the act implied of care. It also really thought about the nuanced understanding of museums as caretakers of collections, and also, and importantly, the agency of artists and objects within these systems. As artists like Gala are increasingly challenging institutional values, I think, and their systems, part of the questions that we have today are, can we move to different definitions of collecting and different understandings of care? So I want to start off really with just sort of placing the role of the museum. It's sort of in its governing mission and DNA. Obviously, the purpose of that is really to take care of, to preserve objects in perpetuity forever, to sort of freeze their material state, to educate the public. But I think this sort of impulse to freeze in time, and it's interesting because the previous conversation with Elvira and Vincent also raised some considerations around the need to kind of control time. And there's a very nice kind of handover to this panel. And I think this sort of impulse to sort of freeze time, the material state of objects, the sort of impulse to resist degradation and decay and loss also raises some ethical considerations because sometimes this can exist in contradiction to the original function of an object, or in the case of working with contemporary artists, the sort of intention of the artist, whether it be an artist working with performance, ephemerality, or objects that are intended to be activated, to be held, to be touched. So I kind of want to start this conversation by kind of posing a question as to the role of conservation. Can the notion of conservation, which is always imbued with a sense of care and taking care of, be seen as sometimes an act of violence? And within that, how are institutions sort of grappling with this tension to both protect and preserve as part of its governing mission, and also to respect the intention of the object and the artist itself? And I wanted to kind of hand over to Gala to just speak a little bit more about this. And in particular, I think one project, Open House, that really dealt with objects whose work had a whole series of changing conditions to the nature of the work itself.